just look at the leg. What are we thinking, Ash? Pack three in there. On the swan. It's looking good. Not many people on. Right, ladies and gents, you join me and Ash at the beautiful Bluebell Fisheries. We have just come off a session at RH's Monument 2 complex. Unfortunately, there was nothing to show for that, so we didn't do any filming. But yeah, we've got a week ahead of us. We've opted to go on Kingfisher Lake. We've been for a walk round. It's about 5 o'clock in the afternoon now. We're all set up. And yeah, we found a spot. So that's what we're fishing. We're on the 2 points now. So yeah, we've got a week ahead of us. It's the end of March now, so the weather is looking a bit hit and miss. The wind is absolutely smashing into us. I don't know if you can see behind, but the wind is absolutely smashing into us. So yeah, it's looking good for a bite, but we will see how it goes. But yeah, I will update you guys as and when anything happens. What a beautiful way to start your morning. Just had to rejig the left hand rod, because on the first morning we've gone and gotten ourselves a bite. It's nothing massive, but the first fish from a new venue is the hardest one to catch, so I'm absolutely over the moon with that. The first morning we got down to Bluebell at around about 3:30 yesterday. Had a walk around for 2 hours. Decided to fish Kingfisher. And yeah, set up. Got base camp up. Got bivvies up and whatnot, because we was mainly aimed towards getting a bivvy up. Rather than getting the rods out, we was just going to flick them out and do all the bits tomorrow. But I got my bivvy up quite quick, so I decided to have a little interrogate of my swim. And yeah, found a spot. So that's where the left hander has gone. And yeah, it's ripped off this morning at 5 to 5. But yeah, I'll go through everything that I'm doing in a little while, but yeah, over the moon with that. That's a result. Can't wait to get it out of the net and show you. The rig side of things, or should I say the hook. So it's just a simple Ronnie rig, pretty much, with a 15mm KLF pop-up on, which is krill leather fish, on a size 4 spinner hook, and then that's just fished on a Ronnie rig, pretty much. But instead of using the conventional boom material and crimping it, I've gone with the Fox Illusion in 20 pounds, and then I'm just loop to looping that on to the swivel at the end. But yeah, there's no swivel or anything on that, because I'm just continuously using the same boom rather than keep changing. So all I need to do is take the kicker off the old rig, hook it on to the new hook, and then slide the kicker back down. But yeah. And then, I didn't put any bait out last night. and I just hooked a PVA mesh bag of crushed boilie. This is the SLK from DNA. I crumbed up a fairly decent sized bucket before I come because it was just sat in the freezer and wasn't really getting used. So I opted to put some of that in to a mesh bag because I was told that that fishy baits work well here, hence why I went with the KLF pop-up as well. So yeah, that's the rod that did the bite. And then I decided to fish exactly the same as what I caught on rig wise, but instead this time I put on a 12 mil Nutty Bee pop-up, which is from JH Baits, so is the KLF. I decided to put one of them on, but that was fished away from that rod, so it was sort of just chucked out really last night as it was dark whilst we was doing the rods. But yeah, that didn't do anything. Fished exactly the same with a bag on. But yeah, so what I've done this time is I've gone with two KLF pop-ups, and then I've put the pink Nutty Bee in the middle of both of them. I've put 8 spots out, 4 over the left hand and 4 over the right hand, and then that is just fished with a mesh bag on, just so I can see whether the fish are actually feeding off of a bit of bait or if they're just sort of picking at it. But yeah, that's what I'm doing at the minute. Seems to be working, but you never know. We've still got quite a few days left. We're on till Saturday and it's now Monday, so yeah, still got quite a few days left. Let's hope we can get amongst the big ones. Right, ladies and gents, so 2:30 this morning, I had a run. Proper screamer, but unfortunately I did lose that one. The rig, the actual boom, snapped on me. So not too sure whether that was just a weak section in the boom when I'd steamed the rig or whatnot, but just had 2 beeps on me middle rod. Bobbin had pulled tight, so I just went down to it for a couple of seconds. Pulled a bit of line back, pulled tight and then dropped back, so I hit into it, got it in towards my peg. There's a snag to my right, there's a big tree that's sort of in the water, and it was just plodding around in the deep margin, and then unfortunately I have lost that one as well to a hook pull. So the tactics are definitely working. I think it's just I think I just need to tweak the rigs a little bit, just so that I can get these carp in or these fish in, whatever it is, because there is some big bream, big tench in Kingfisher. So yeah, redone the rod, just need to clip a hooker mesh bag on and then fire it out, and then hopefully I get another chance at one. But yeah, 2 fish lost this morning, which isn't great, but it shows that there's something definitely in the area. So yeah, I'll put the camera down now, hook this mesh bag on and fire it back out. Only 21 falling from here.
Drops up to 15. It drops up, so thank you.
Lovely, lovely common. Fucking get in! Second bite of the session. Let's go.
Bye. After a move yesterday into the second point, lost two, one this morning and lost two yesterday. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning and I've been graced with a brand new PB, dead on, 36 pound. It's going mad at the minute. Not over a lot of bait at all. It's over a small mesh bag of boilie crumb. A new personal best, 36 pound. Absolutely made up with that. Get in.
You don't even believe what's happened. One rod went. Somehow we've got two pike and the landing net. He is the littler of the two.
Fucking hell.
Don't think Finn likes him.
No, I don't. Horrible fucking things.
All I could think of is if one's followed the other one into the net.
There's one.
There's the baby.
I'll get Big Mama out.
Oh, he went for Jan then. Sausage fingers. There's the second one.
Mate.
Shall we weigh the bigger one, just see how big it is?
Weird creatures, aren't they, these? Yeah.
Two pike, one 12 mil.
12 mil, pink. Nutty B, pink popper.
Oh,
fuck, right.
Language, Finley.
You know, I don't like these.
Oh, just get him back in.
Right, we'll put the smaller one back.
For the other one with the sling, mate. Wind's pushing right into us today. Well, into Finn, should I say.
£36, and then, well, my first and second ever pike, so that's a new PB pike of 16 and
which one was zooked though, that's the question.
It doesn't matter which one was zooked. They They were both in my landing net. Get it gone. Mate, that's a weird creature that is. He doesn't want to go anywhere.
Looks like your hands.
Go on.
Off he goes.
It's full. That's weird, isn't it? Right, so another fish, and the exact same day as I had the 36 pounder, and we've been graced with another common straight out into the middle of the lake, 17 wraps, lovely spot that goes from silt and then to slight patches of gravel. So
pubes.
I'm just fishing in the silt and not on the gravel. On a Ronnie, with a KLF pop up, 15mm, with a PVA mesh bag of crumbed up boilies. What another result. And we've still got quite a few days left of the session. Absolutely buzzing.
Hey!
Well, nice little half past one wake up call this morning. This lovely mirror, but it's not wanting to play ball, it's not wanting to have a photo. It's flopping round and it's got me absolutely piss wet through. We'll try one more time, and if it doesn't, it doesn't. I'll just put it back. There we go. Lovely little mirror. I reckon roughly about 20, maybe a bit less, 18 pound. We haven't weighed it yet. But yeah, absolutely. Six bites from core, four fish landed. Let's hope we can get some more.
One thing, and that was for one of these big commons. I've just been graced with it after losing two, snapping twice, I think swan mussels. All my line kept coming in, all frayed, and I'd lost a fish. This one, right hand rod, two beeps. I was sitting on the end of my rod, waiting it into it. I've been graced with this 46 pound beautiful common. Oh, sticking.
He is absolutely a gem.
Look at that. Get in, that's what we come for. Thank you.
And away she fucking goes. Come on.
Yes.
Absolutely blowing a gale. 42 mile an hour winds.
Hot boxing the baby with Dacker
and style. It's absolutely blowing a gale. Ash's baby is shaking like mad.
Oh, we've got two
PBs
and that's all that counts. Bluebell!
Pissing it down and it's windy, so we're taking shelter. Update you guys in a bit if anything happens. Good much Premier League darts. So yeah, happy days on the bank.
A week fishing at Bluebell, me and Finn, Thursday night, Premier League darts, couple of cans of Stella, here we go.
We are eating like kings.
on this fucking on this session. Absolute kings.
Wow. Just having a morning brew and a few biscuits, and the right rod beat twice, and we've managed to land yet another fish. That's a bite every morning so far since we've been here at Bluebell, which is an absolute result for on here, because it's not an easy water by any means, but it just goes to show a rig in the right place.
It's dancing.
A rig in the right place can produce yet another fish. A new PB again. 40, what was it, 40 pounds?
40 pounds, 15.
15 ounces. So me and Ash have both joined the 40 club on this session. Absolutely buzzing. I don't think any of us could have imagined what would have happened on this session. Two 40 pounders, both commons, PBs absolutely smashed. What a result, and what a way to go into sort of the last full day of the session. Absolutely buzzing. We'll get her back, put the rod back in, and catch another one. Come on. Go on then. Come on. Yes.
The sauce.
Last day, and Ash has had a run. About 10 o'clock now, isn't it, Ash? Packing up at 11, leaving the rods until 11. Everything's been put away, both sides. And his middle rod has just gone. Get in.
So after speaking to a few members and asking about the fish, the 40s that me and Ash have caught, mine was an unnamed 40 and the new 40 for the lake. So I get to name that. So I'm going to speak to Trev, the bailiff, and I'm going to name that one. And what was yours called, Ash?
Fethead.
Suits the name and suits the angler, doesn't it?
Not really,
no. But yeah. So Ash has caught a named 40, and then I get to name the 40 that I caught. So yeah, we've had a banging session. Obviously, you've seen Ash has had another bite on the last morning. So yeah, it's been a productive session. I've had 133 pound worth of fish. Well, carp anyway, and then obviously those two pike, but they don't really count when you're carp fishing. And then Ash has done pretty well for himself with a new PB.
All good.
Banging.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Right now, I got to tell you about the fabulous, most groovy bell bottoms. Bell bottoms.